Hi everyone, I'm Vikram Shah, MCAT expert and 528 scorer. Today I'm going to tell you how to study for the MCAT. We'll go over the exact same strategies I use to achieve a perfect score on the MCAT. Your MCAT score is a critical component of your medical school application. If you're applying to medical school, you must take this exam, and scoring well on the test will greatly increase your admissions odds. But the secret is, there's more to scoring well in the MCAT than just being really, really proficient in the sciences. In this video, I'll share 7 high-yield study strategies so you can achieve your best score on the MCAT. Tip number 1, develop a study schedule early. The first thing that I did when studying for the MCAT was build a comprehensive study schedule. On average, students spend about 3 months studying for the exam, and you should build your study schedule as soon as you've selected your test date. Many students wonder, why is it so important to build a study schedule? Building a study schedule is important for 2 reasons. 1, it holds you accountable, and 2, it provides a day-by-day, week-by-week, and month-by-month roadmap to your test prep. This means you won't need to spend extra energy figuring out what material you should be focusing on each time you sit down to study. Accountability is important when studying for the MCAT, as it is often easy to fall behind. Once you've committed to a test date, you can build a study schedule that will ensure you're prepared come test day. The roadmap is important in your test prep so that you can see how far you've come and where you still need to go. At the end of each week, you can look back at what you've accomplished that week and have clarity on what you'll need to tackle the following week. Tip number 2, build flex days into your study schedule. Burnout is very common among pre-med students who are studying for the MCAT. For that reason, it is absolutely necessary that when you study for the MCAT, you build flexibility into your study schedule so that you can catch up when life, school, or work inevitably get in the way. There are a couple ways to do this. Option 1, build a flex day into every week. Designate a day of the week that you don't plan any MCAT studying. If you fall behind on studying during the week, you can use this day to catch up. If you stayed caught up all week, you can use this day to relax and take a short break from the test so that you can come back reinvigorated the next week. Option 2 is to leave 1 to 2 open weeks at the end of your study schedule before your test date. In other words, pretend that you're taking the MCAT 1 to 2 weeks earlier than your scheduled test date, so when life gets in the way, you can adjust your study schedule to take advantage of that flexibility time. When I studied for the exam, I treated it as a 9-to-5 job for 8 weeks. Importantly, I didn't treat it as a 24/7 job. This helped me stay focused during the 8 hours of productivity during the day, while giving me a break in the evening. In addition, I did not study for the exam most weekends, and this allowed me to approach the exam refreshed and ready each week. Though many people study for the exam while juggling other responsibilities, it is still very helpful to specifically outline the amount of time that you will study. No more and no less. Again, this will help improve your efficiency and prevent burnout so you can achieve your highest score. Tip number 3, value perfect practice over practice. A famous football coach named Vince Lombardi once said, "Practice doesn't make perfect, perfect practice makes perfect." Practice on the MCAT involves taking as many passages as you can. Perfect practice involves taking passages, reviewing your mistakes, writing down what you need to learn, and most importantly, studying to make sure you don't make those same mistakes again. I can't emphasize this enough. Thoroughly tracking, writing down, and studying your mistakes is the single best way to improve your MCAT score. As a general rule of thumb, you should spend almost as much time reviewing the passage as you spend taking the passage. You should also spend time studying what you missed, which is a key step that students often forget. You should approach each test with a new body of knowledge and a solidified understanding of what you have missed before. So, before taking your 8th full-length exam, make sure that you've gone through the previous 7, written down what you missed, and studied that information carefully. Tip number 4, emphasize practice and study content based on what you miss in practice. One of the biggest mistakes that students make is studying low-yield content that is unlikely to show up on the exam. For example, you are better off knowing the 20 amino acids backwards and forwards than knowing how to solve a projectile motion problem involving a rock flying off of a cliff. The MCAT is more likely to ask questions in a biological context, so be aware of where you're spending your time, especially if you're studying on a tight schedule. As you progress further in your medical training, you'll begin shifting your test preparation attitude from studying content to completing practice problems. In fact, USMLE Step 1 and Step 2 preparation relies almost exclusively on completing practice problems and then reviewing the content. The MCAT is very similar in this regard. Students who complete practice problems and then study what they missed tend to do very well compared to students who rely too heavily on content review. Before you take the MCAT, you will have taken hundreds of practice problems, many of which come from the people who write the test, also known as the American Association of Medical Colleges, or AAMC. As a result, you will have a good idea of the topics that you tend to miss questions on. For example, if you keep missing questions on thermodynamics, then go back to the book and study thermodynamics so that you approach your next full length with an understanding of both the topic and how the MCAT likes to ask questions on that topic. Tip number 5, go through all of the AAMC materials at least once. I often recommend saving the AAMC materials for the final phase of a student's test prep. This does not mean, however, that you should be rushing to complete all of the AAMC question packs in the week leading up to your test. Rather, you should schedule the AAMC resources appropriately so that you have time to complete them without rushing, while also going through all of the questions at least once. Make sure to give yourself enough time to make it through these resources. Since the AAMC writes the exam, these are going to be the most test-like questions you will complete during your practice. Tip number 6, simulate real testing conditions when taking full-length practice exams. I often hear stories of students scoring in the 515 to 520 range on their AAMC practice exams, and then scoring 5 to 10 points lower on the real thing. Many students score very well on their AAMC practice exams leading up to test day, and then score a few or several points lower on the actual test. There are a few reasons why this happens. First, it is very important that you simulate test-like conditions on your practice AAMC full-length exams. Try to find a quiet location where you will not be disturbed while taking the exam. In addition, make sure you begin the exam at 8 a.m. You should take all of your breaks, both when you practice and when you take the real exam. The breaks are a time for you to use the restroom, fuel up on snacks and water, and recharge for the next section. In line with simulating real testing conditions, it is very common for students who are excited to see their score to rush through the psychology and sociology section, which is the final section of the exam. You should not rush through the section on test day, so there's no reason for you to rush through it when you're practicing. Remember, psychology and sociology make up 1/4 of your overall score. Additionally, you should not have the mindset, "I will just guess on this question since it is a practice test, and review it after I submit the exam." Part of taking the exam is encountering questions that you might not know how to approach. Treat these questions like they're happening on the actual test, and approach them as you would any other question. By trying to reason through these more difficult questions, you begin learning how to answer them, despite maybe not knowing exactly what the right answer is. Tip number 7, stick to your strategy on test day. Students often find the first section of the MCAT, chemistry and physics, to be the most difficult section of the exam. On test day, if they get a difficult chem-phys section, that may throw them off for the rest of the exam. So here, I will make a football analogy. It is often said that the quarterback of a football team must have a short memory so that if he throws an interception, it does not rattle his confidence the next time he has the ball. In the same way, you should have a short memory while you're taking the MCAT. If you are spending 10% of your brain power during the second section of the exam thinking about the first section of the exam, that is valuable brain power that you could be spending on the second section of the exam. In other words, don't dwell on a difficult previous section and allow it to hurt your score on the remaining sections. In addition, students often deviate from the strategy they practiced with when they take the real exam. Test day is not the day to stop using your strategy or change strategies. Stick with your strategy, even if it feels like it is not working. By simulating test day more closely during your other practice exams, you can build the confidence to stick with your strategy on test day. And that's how to study for the MCAT. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss out on new videos. And if you'd like to receive a free MCAT question of the day so you can get every last bit of practice in before test day, click the link in the description. Thanks again for watching, and see you next time.